father, when did you start as an educator?
I started in the year 2008. I worked in Gonda Fatima College. Then next, I worked in Indira Nagar St. Dominic's College as a vice principal. And 2012, vice principal of St. Francis College, Lucknow.
So, what is the current status of awareness about and awareness and importance about education in India, according to your observations?
I have worked not only in a school. Prior to this, I worked in as a director of an NGO.
Okay.
So I have gone through my all UP Uttar Pradesh especially. I have seen education strategies. I think only 50 to 60%.
Okay.
Education not reached especially towards the girl child.
Okay.
Girl child education is very very poor in India, especially in North India. So it's very alarming data which we see.
So don't you think that we know that girl child education is not as it should be in Northern India, but it has improved in past decade.
Yes.
Right.
Due to school abhiyan, government initiatives, it has impact. But still the people, the parents, still they, because they are farmers and they are uneducated, illiterate, due to that, that they have that in their mind, girls education is not important.
What are the challenges you face during your service as an educator?
As an educator, I have seen media playing a great role to the present youth and especially the children today. They are used to mobile and all other media, and which has affected their own studies. They are weak in handwriting, weak in their eyesight, weak because they don't know. Mentally, physically, they are becoming weaker because they are spending more time in this electronic gadgets than earlier we used to study, we used to read books. That habit is not there with the children. That is a very big impact which is coming. And secondly, the government rules which has come now, where we cannot beat, we cannot touch, we cannot scold. And the children today are more aware, more than us, they are aware. That has made us that we are powerless in times. They are taking the right hand, and they are that the discipline is coming down. That's what we.
So the discipline is the major concern.
Major concern today,
right?
Yeah. Okay. It is not only external discipline, but also internally, the internal discipline, then morality, it also coming down.
Okay. What do you think about the impact of technology in education?
Impact. There is a very very much it has impact positive as well. If you take it in positive, it is very good, it is very much informative, and people are, the children, even all teachers also updated with all. Today we have smart classes, which is very good, because we get the knowledge of the whole world at a time, at a glance we get the information and knowledge. But very happy, very good, very happy.
So you were talking about a smart class and the positive impact, merits of the technology.
Yeah.
So what are the demerits of technology in education?
As I have said, because children are addicted to mobiles, they are supposed to spend more time in books and studies and writing and keeping the notes, but they don't. They are used to mobile, and even they keep take the notes through the WhatsApp, through the mobile they get question answers.
Okay.
So the teaching, they are not paying attention to the teaching in the class. They pay attention to the mobile and their computers.
Okay. So, there are two dimensions of technology in education. One is in teaching methodologies, like smart classes that you mentioned.
Yeah.
And the other is the analysis of the performance of students and teachers.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm.
So, most of the schools and educators are focused on the teaching methodologies.
Yes.
Right? But they are not taking analysis of reports and performance of the students and teachers as they should take.
Yes.
So what's your views on that?
I am looking at both the sides. We need to improve in that, what I feel.
Mm-hmm.
And in, as I am here in this school, and I am taking keen interest, and I feel that we have to work both together.
Mm-hmm.
Even teachers, school, staff, everyone come together, work together for their development. And also that keep up that standard of the school. and education.
Okay. So actually, my question was isme tha. So there are five types of technology that we are using in learning.
Yeah.
Right. One is the teaching methodologies. The other one is, you have heard about Walmart. When you walk into a Walmart store, you already get a message that whatever you have came to buy in a store is in this section. Matlab they know that what you have come to buy. They already know what you're going to buy at their store. Why? Because of the analytical history of your previous purchases at the store.
Okay.
And not just previous purchases, but on many dimensions. Like what are your age group is, when did you marry, how many families are, how many members are in your families, okay, what are your eating habits, they are tracking everything, right, and they know what you have come for, aap kya khareedne wale. So this is using, right, every company is using in marketing especially, right, Facebook is using that, same things, political parties are using nowadays, right, so how do we leverage this technology, this artificial intelligence, data analytics in education? What do you think?
I think for this, first of all, we teachers should be trained.
Right.
Yeah, they need to be trained. They we need some trainers to come, because it has not reached to this school up to now. Even smart class not there here. We don't have.
Okay.
But it has not reached. So we need someone to come and train us so that we take up this.
Right.
And then that bring changes in our education system.
Right. So you are suggesting that before reaching out to students, we have to work on our educators, teachers, right?
Yeah.
To so they can be comfortable with the technology and not just teaching, but the analysis and reporting. We also heard about personalized learning in the London Summit. There is a summit in London, London named Learn It World Education Summit. So they were talking about personalized learning. Like we teach in this class with the 50 students in a section, right? So each one of the students have different kind of mindset, different kind of qualities, right? How can we teach same thing to every student? So they were talking about how can we implement the personalized learning.
Yeah.
Personalized learning for every student by leveraging the technology. So what do you think? What's your views on that?
I have not gone for this meeting and all.
Okay.
But I personally have an keen interest. But as I said that we want to go for it.
Okay.
And we want to update and go with the technology also. Come go forward, not go backward.
Right.
We are going backward. So let us go together. Science also we need together. We need to go ahead with that. We have also like compete with the others, like international schools.
Right.
Even Lucknow, we have some schools now. Children come with the tablet. We started Lucknow. So we want to go forward. But it may have some other impact, other negative impact.
Right.
Still, we have to go little together, almost not completely together, but at least.
So you're saying that as educator, you have to be very careful with the negative impact of the technology. You have to be controlling part of that.
Yes.
Right? Okay. So, do you really think, you mentioned that international schools, right? So, they charge hefty fee, right?
Yes.
They have technologies and they pay really well to teachers also.
Yeah.
So, do you really think that poor kids can perform as well as rich kids with all those technological resources on the hand?
Sure, indeed. Everything is possible. In India, everything is possible. Provided we have a broad mind, broad-hearted, we can all educate and bring all children to one platform. We can do that.
Okay. So, where do you want to go from here? I mean, what are the things that you want to do more in your life in education sector and educating people?
Now, at present, I'm taking interest in this place, in Ahmedabad, here. Because here is so many years, it is only till class 10. So my interest is go for 12th standard.
Okay.
After the 12th standard, so that it comes up, the school comes up. Then we implement all the, it will update and it will make it into the most standard school.
Yes, you're right.
Yeah.
I'm impressed about that, because when Faz was studying as a kid in this school,
it
was a 10th standard, right? And still it is.
I'm very happy to meet Faz, and he's doing very wonderful work he is doing, and it's good for us that he comes to support us in the days to come.